आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एट होम. आई होप दैट योर हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम्स वर गुड. सो आफ्टर हाफ ईयरली एग्जाम नाउ वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ इवनिंग्स. सो आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज एक्वाटिक प्लांट्स विच इज अंडर क्लास 5 सब्जेक्ट EBS चैप्टर नंबर 18 दे लिव इन वाटर. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज दे लिव इन वाटर. ओके सो फ्रॉम द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर दे लिव इन वाटर ओनली यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट वी विल लर्न अबाउट डिफरेंट प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स लिविंग इन द वाटर इन दिस चैप्टर. सो आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज एक्वाटिक प्लांट्स. एक्वाटिक प्लांट्स आर द प्लांट्स विच ग्रोज इन वाटर. ओके सो लाइक दैट वाटर इज ऑल्सो अ होम टू मिलियंस ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स. लाइक प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स लिव ऑन लैंड लाइक दैट वाटर इज ऑल्सो अ होम टू मिलियंस ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स.
First, we will learn about free floating plants. Students, this picture shows free floating plants. These plants float on the surface of water. Their roots are not fixed to the soil at the bottom of the water body. Such roots absorb nutrients directly from water. Free floating plants have spongy, air-filled parts to make them extra light so that they can float easily. Their leaves provide shade to small water animals. Water lettuce, water hyacinth, and duckweed are examples of free floating plants. Next, we will learn about rooted floating plants. This picture shows rooted floating plants. These plants also float on the surface of water, but their roots are fixed to the water bed. The stems of such plants are long and hollow. This helps to bring leaves to the surface of water. The leaves of rooted floating plants are broad and floating. Lotus and water lily are examples of rooted floating plants. Next, we will learn about submerged plants. Submerged plants grow totally under water. Their roots are fixed to the water bed. They have long, narrow leaves. Submerged plants absorb carbon dioxide given out by the aquatic animals. Thus, they help to keep the water clean. Hydrilla, tape grass, and vallisneria are a few submerged plants. Next, students, we will learn about emergent plants. Emergent plants usually grow in wetlands and along the shore where water is not too deep. Their lower parts are often submerged under water. They have long, narrow leaves that extend out of water. This helps them to bend easily with water waves or high winds. Some examples of emergent plants are bulrush and aurum lily.
So students, this is all about today's topic, that is aquatic plants. I hope students you have understood today's topic properly. I hope students you have understood about the different types of aquatic plants. And you have seen their pictures also, so I hope it is clear to you. So study properly, stay safe at home, and